So, hi everybody. I would like to present a recently developed workflow for the digitization of audiovisual records in the archives of social democracy, in which open source tools play a decisive role. First, let me give you a brief introduction of the context in which the workflow was developed. Then I will introduce you to the workflow and finally formulate a few perspective thoughts. The Archives of Social Democracy of the Friedrich Ebert Stiftung, based in Bonn in Germany, collects sources on the history of the German and in part also of the international labor movement. Besides nearly 56 kilometers of written documents, our collection also includes over 50,000 analog media objects, but unfortunately, for the most part, they are not appraised, classified, or cataloged. In order to counteract this deficit, since July 2017, a comprehensive evaluation of the collection was carried out as part of a two-year project in order to optimize and standardize the relevant work processes. One of these processes, the workflow for the digitization of analog videotapes, I would like to present you in the following. In a first phase, the videotapes are inspected and photographed, and related enclosures are scanned. In addition, the analog tapes are cataloged as individual objects in our archive information system. In general, the resulting metadata, regardless of whether they document the digitization process, the content or technical aspects, are either manually entered in our archive information system or attached as a file to the corresponding record. The same applies to the resulting photos. The same applies to the resulting photos and scans, which are also attached to the record. After this preliminary phase comes the actual digitization. We work with various tape players, TBCs, measuring instruments, breakout boxes, and workstations. Regarding the limited time, I don't want to go deeper into the technical settings. For capturing, we use Adobe's Premiere and Blackmagic's Media Express. At this point, one could also use open source tools like WeRecord, but as Premiere and Media Express are available in our department anyway, this solution seemed to be more comfortable. After capturing, the first quality assurance can be done by with QC tools, a very powerful tool by Media Area that requires a certain amount of training. So that's, to be honest, at the moment, we only look out for some major issues. Next, we use FFmpeg for the conversion into the target formats. We wanted to preserve a lossless archive master, so we decided to use FFV1 because of storage density. In addition, an access copy is created in H.264. Mezzanines, we use IMX50, are only created of frequently requested movies or on demand. We use the graphical user interface FF command, which makes it easy to create batch jobs. At this point, I want to refer to FFmprovisor and Retrochroma's FFmpeg cookbook for archivists, which have been extremely helpful. In order to assure the quality, the technical parameters such as the video and audio codec, bit rates, resolution, etc., are first checked by MediaConch using a previously defined policy. A MediaConch test report and media info metadata are exported as XML files and passed on to the archive information system. This is followed by a visual examination, which checks at least at the beginning, at the middle, and at the end of the recording various aspects such as image and sound levels, synchronicity, or the coloring. Depending on the staff resources, a complete view of the digitized document can be made, in the course of which content metadata can also be gathered. The storage and long-term preservation of the video files were initially a major challenge for us. At the Archives of Social Democracy, we are currently implementing a new interdivisional software, which should in the future basically take over the task of long-term preservation. But initially, the system is mainly designed for the handling of written documents. So the storage capacity of the digital repository is limited, and the whole system is not prepared for the large amount of data which comes up in the course of video or film digitization. Therefore, at least temporary, an independent solution for the media archive had to be found and has been found. So basically, the backup is done, is now done on two different storage media, LTO and HDD. The derivative copies are stored with an MD5 checksum on a RAID 5 secured NAS with a backup on LTO8. The archive masters are packed into Bagged packages using Bagger, a graphical user interface developed by the Library of Congress. The packages also include some XML files with metadata, as well as the object photos taken in the first phase of this workflow and the scanned enclosures. Then the bags are copied on two LTO8 tapes and one hard disk. Since we just wanted to get started easily, we did not want to install a LTO tape library, so we just connected an LTO8 single drive to our workstation. For each LTO tape that can store a total of 12 terabytes, there's a correspondingly large hard disk that is connected to the workstation via a simple HDD docking station. The hard disk and one LTO tape are stored at different locations in our office in Bonn, while the second LTO tape is brought to our office in Berlin at a distance of over 600 kilometers. With these solutions, we follow the 3-to-1 principle by keeping a total of 3 copies on 2 different storage media and 1 copy in a geographically different location. As the title of this talk should clarify, we are just at the beginning of our digitization efforts. I am aware that the workflow in its current version has weaknesses, especially since many processes still have to be initiated manually. But above all, it was important for us to finally start in a structured manner in order to counteract the increasing degradation of analog video material. Prospectively, the workflow should be integrated into our comprehensive interdivisional concept for digital long-term preservation. Especially the storage phases should be operated by the corresponding software. Well, since I somehow underestimated the brevity of a lightning talk, please forgive me that I have not dealt with every detail of the workflow properly. But if you have any further questions after the Q&A, please ask me anytime during the coffee breaks, or feel free to contact me via email. Thank you.